Hello, friends. Welcome to Mall Mayhem. So, as you saw with the quickie intro I put together, which was actually more of an experiment with Sony Vegas, I'm going to try to do more interesting things with that because I don't use it nearly to the potential that it could be used, and I paid a lot of money for that program. So I figure we should get some use out of it. So, this game, Mall Mayhem, just came out on the 6th, I believe, of October. Saw this as a game that reminded me a lot of Carmageddon or Car Wars or one of those things where you're in a car and you destroy things. Basically, you are in a mall that has gone bankrupt and you own a wrecking company and you need to tear down the mall, but your wrecking company is so shady that you have to use your car to do it. Now, I was a little bit disillusioned about the Car Wars and the Carmageddon connection when I got to start playing it, but the game still does have some value. Are there some things the developer could probably do better? Probably. But I requested a key of this to play it because I was really interested in the project, and honestly, I still am, even with the shortcomings that I did find, and I'll show you what those are as we play it. Because I've played about a few hours of this game already trying to pin down what it is. But first, before we get started with actually playing, let me tell you a little bit about the game. The game is produced by and distributed by Titanium Game Studios, and it is on sale right now at retail price on Steam for $3.99. And honestly, I think for $3.99, it's definitely worth it. So I would say if this interests you, and honestly, I'm playing a very early copy of the game since it had just come out, so I have a feeling some of these issues that I'm seeing are probably going to be fixed by the time you guys see this. The developer seems to be kind of on top of things. So anyway, I requested a key for this. They sent me one. So this was provided by the developer. So just for full disclosure there, but let's go over how to play. So basics of the game: you smash objects, gain points, bigger objects give more points. You have to keep moving. If the vehicle's still for even just a couple seconds, it blows up. You can add modes to make the game harder to play, and they increase the multiplier. Multiplier increases your score. You get abilities, which I have not yet had a chance to get yet. Pretty standard controls: W, S, forward and back, A and D, left and right. Left shift is a handbrake. Spacebar uses the ability. And the number keys, of course, as you can see here, select your different abilities, which do different things. And 6 will give up. And the escape and the M key will bring up the settings menu. So these little blue guys running around over here are shoppers that are still trying to protest shopping in the mall, which I understand why they're there, but it's kind of contradictory to the story. Because basically the premise is that online shopping has destroyed the economy in this mall. If that was the case, then these shoppers wouldn't really be running around. Maybe it'd be more effective to call them looters than shoppers. Just a thought. If you hit one of these guys, you lose a life. And they're very easy to hit, very easy to knock over, so it's very easy to lose lives. The number of lives you give yourself is adjustable between 0 and 5. So these are your lives, categorized by the M up here. Your ability cooldowns show up down here. Your current ability is listed here on the menu screen. This is your score. This is your multiplier. And that's pretty much the UI. So let's go back and let's start a game. So these are the modes you can play. Blackout turns out all the lights and you play with your headlights. The hardest difficulty I could see going was blackout with slippery floors and deadly walls, because you can't see the walls quick enough. And Black Friday, because you die almost instantly because there's a bunch of people in there. But that'll increase your your score drastically. Now, slippery floors worked well at first for me, but when I was playing it, I slid sideways into things and high-sided too often. Blackout was interesting, but extremely difficult. Earthquake just as a visual problem for me, honestly made me a little bit seasick. This one needs some work, I think, because it's, I don't even want to play it. It's so visually unappealing. So hopefully this is one of the things that they bring into it. Inversion turns everything upside down. Deadly walls, if you hit a wall, you die. And Black Friday just adds a bunch of new people. So you can increase your lives here or decrease them. We're going to go to 5 because I want to get a good amount of play out of this so you can see it. Not that it really matters because we will probably get high-sided and stuck to start with. So your abilities, boost, radial force, balls of steel, second chance, and ghost. Boost kind of rockets you out of things, and you need to get 100,000 points in Mall 1 to unlock it. Radial force, I don't know, but it's probably like an outward force to blow things away from you. You need 400,000 points in Mall 4 to unlock that. Balls of steel is 200,000 points in Mall 2. And second chance, which resets you back to the beginning, you need 500,000 points in Mall 5. And ghost, which lets you drive through the shoppers, 300,000 points in Mall 3. And since we have unlocked none of those abilities, we can't use any. So there are currently 6 malls you could choose from, which each have a different floor plan, but it's identical every time you play it. They're not procedurally generated, which is good because it kind of gives you an idea of strategy that you can put in mind. So let's start with Mall 1. Now, keep in mind, there's not a lot of stopping once you get started, so commentary may be low. So, Mall 1 builds the mall. There's our car. We have no abilities. We're at a times 1 multiplier, so we'll back up and hit that bench. And then we'll go forward and hit that. Kind of come around the corner, try not to hit this guy. Every time the keep moving sign comes up, you're in great danger of completely losing the game. What I found generally is small movements seem to work fairly well. And if you get too much speed, that's what happens. You end up high-sided on a piece of something and can't move. Let's try again. Do Mall 1 again. So, one problem that I did have with this was that hit a guy. It's very easy to get stuck on small objects. And the camera does not adjust automatically. So you can do E and turn the camera, which makes it easier to see what you're driving into. But you do have to keep in mind that that is something you need to change yourself, and not something the game is going to do for you. And we're high-sided again. So, as you can see, we got stuck in a plant, and that was the end of us. Let's try another mall, just so you can see some of the different floor plans. We'll do Mall 2. And Mall 2 is fairly similar to Mall 1. Sometimes it's easier to glance into things than it is to actually hit them. Because when you start pushing things and backing over things is generally a bad idea, because apparently your car is rear-wheel drive. Hit a guy. And that was a bad plan. Now, one thing I would suggest maybe they come up with for this game is different types of vehicles. Like, you could get a bulldozer, maybe a crane, maybe something bigger, something with bigger tires. Because as you can see, we're running up on it things rather easily. And the surface area is not clearing very well. So you kind of have to shove things along. And generally, by the time you realize you're stuck, it's too late to do anything. So, like I said, backing up, not necessarily the best idea in the world. And we're stuck. So you could see that was really unexpected that that got under our tire and just put us up there. All right, let's check out Mall 3. I thought maybe, you know, this would be really good about smashing and running into things, but you know, like I said, the problem comes in is that things tend to get in your way. And get under your wheels. And then you're done for. So backing up, not always the smartest move. But slow progress should kind of get you where you need to go. Because when you go slow, it seems like you don't get hung up on as much, but we're stuck on that. Like I said, backing up is not always your friend. Boost would probably help a bunch in those situations. Whoa, don't back up. Where you're trying to get over things and can't. Sometimes shoving things helps. You just have to make sure you have a clear path behind you. Because if we were to back up on any of this nonsense, it would lock us up in an instant. And control is sometimes an issue. You know, I do like the fact that even though you have to keep moving, there's no penalty for not breaking things for a minute or two. See if we can get in here. There we go. Breaking my cardinal rule there by backing over things. I think this would be a interesting adventure with controller support. I'm not sure if you can program controller with this game, but that might make it a little bit more finessed. Easier to play. I mean, I will let you make your own decision as to whether you think the game is good playability or not. But oh, now we're stuck. I got going backwards too fast. That's not a bad score, I mean. It was a fun mall. Which one were we? I think that was 3. So let's do mall 4. Let's try to get this outside part done. We can avoid the really, no need to check this out over here, buddy. You can just keep doing what you're doing. Let's go back along here, pick up these points. And that is me manually adjusting the camera, by the way. You know, yeah, I saw this game and the first thing that came to mind was the Blues Brothers. So that was also on my mind when I was looking at it. And that just really isn't here. I mean, it's not the... I mean, I guess it could be the same, but... Comparison... Ooh. Got a little bit of a clipping issue there. Running into something is a stop. So, can't even pause for a second to examine what you're doing. So, a lot of very quick made decisions. Okay. And sometimes you flip over. We're doing really good there for a minute. All right, let's check out Mall 5. So you can see the different floor plans. Let's go around the outside so you can see it. Those guys have no sense of self-preservation. I mean, it's kind of cool because you can watch the wheels spin. Let's do that one again. I don't think we gave it justice. These guys just go all out trying to get run down, I think. Kind of running every which way, and I think we're stuck. Nope, we got out. Quit backing up. Oh, we'll give it credit for this. Whatever vehicle this is, it's fairly durable. This mall's got everything. Again, we'll just work our way across the floor. So as long as we're moving, we're doing all right. It's when we stop moving that it becomes a problem. Or we start going up in there. Push this a little bit. Whoa. Act kind of like a broom. Points for this. Stuff must already be broken. All right, we're not getting anything more in here for a little bit. Got a guy. Nope. Hey, music store. I mean, the one good thing is when you're in the stores, you get a bit of a break from the pedestrians, the shoppers. So that's good. Like I said, having the ability to get different vehicles would make this really cool. Being able to upgrade your vehicle would be cool. Having the ability to buy like a cow catcher or a plow for the front or bigger tires would be kind of cool. I mean, I'm pretty sure the physics in this aren't so hard and fast that bigger tires would totally make the game broken. Not getting a good angle for that. There's a lot of shoppers here. I mean, you would kind of think that these guys would want to get the heck out of a mall that's being destroyed. Well, these break up pretty easy. But they splinter really well. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Definitely super, super easy to get under your tires, especially the back tires, and get you stuck. Alright, my one other suggestion. To the developers would be have the camera auto rotate. Because that would make it so much easier to actually see what you're doing. Because hitting the Q and the E key, not always something that's available. Hey, we got second chance ability unlocked. So we unlocked an ability. And an achievement. And we're stuck. There you go. Was that, which mall was that? 4? 5? Second chance. So second chance you only use once. I think I was 5. So let's look at 6. And these are the 6 malls that are available for us. And I wish I could say that it was totally skill based as far as playing and winning. But that's not really the case, because you can be watching very carefully as to how you're tires are doing and run up on something very quickly. And get stuck. Just like that. Let's try this one again. Some of the doorways are, would probably be a problem if they made extra vehicles. I could kind of see that, because they are very narrow. We used our second chance ability because we got stuck. Boost would have been nice as an alternative. Rocket out of here. Oop. See, I kind of saw that I was still moving. It decided I was not. So let's try Slippery Floors. We'll do Mall 5. We seem to do fairly well on that one. So this is with Slippery Floors. And the problem I had with the Slippery Floors was gaining traction sometimes was not stopping and gaining traction, not usually as effective. I mean, we're not talking about a total Tokyo Drift situation going on here. Oh. Yeah, there's the issue. when you get stuck when using slippery floors, you can't pull yourself up. And when you've bounced off something, sometimes the rebound is fairly extreme. This seems to be our mall. And pushing with slippery floors, not always something you can do. Slippery floors will actually block you from pushing. But it does have some fun effects, and we are getting a times 4 score. There's a door. Not the sign down, it's hard to tell where the actual door is. Sorry, buddy. Ah. Couldn't do anything. Sliding right into him. Anyway, 469,000. So I think you got a good idea of what this is. Maybe we'll do some other modes. So let's do blackout. So you can see what it's like to play with it blacked out. And we'll just do Mall 1. So this is blackout mode. And I am glad there is no structural damage on your car for hitting things. In here, it's not as much of an issue. It's easier to get stuck, like we're going to do in here in a second. Alright, well, we used second chance and got stuck again. But that's blackout. Now, I will show you one more mode, and that's earthquake. And I want you to see why this is the only mode, I think. We need to turn that up. That, I wish this also stayed. But earthquake, I'll show you earthquake, and you can see why I don't like it and why I think it needs some improvement. Are you seasick yet? Because I am. It's really hard to tell when you're stuck. Alright, so that's earthquake mode. Doesn't help you in any way. Doesn't take away from your score. It just makes the screen shake. And I guess there's a timer that probably runs down to where it destroys it. So anyway, in its current incarnation, this is Mall Mayhem. Would I recommend that you go out and buy it? If you had $5 to spend, there's worse things you can spend your money on. I actually have enjoyed the hours that I've gotten out of this game. And how much hour per dollar do you need to get before you actually like what you're doing? I could see playing this often. I can tell every time I play it, I get a little further. So there's some progress there. There's some things, though, that I think would make this game better. If you start on Mall 1 and there's progress up to Mall 6 in difficulty, where it had a progression so that maybe there were like a couple of guys running around and the objects broke down a little bit differently so they didn't get under your tires so easily. Maybe bigger objects or whatnot so you couldn't drive up on them. I also would like to see the ability to upgrade your vehicle, bigger tires. Things like that. More powerful engines, so you better brakes. Those are all things I would like to see. One thing that I do think this game is missing is a tutorial. Not necessarily a tutorial to teach you how to play the game, but a tutorial will allow you to hone your driving skills in this game a little bit, because having the ability to play the game in an open environment with just some obstacles in it, no walls and no shoppers, would make it a lot less difficult to get into the game and get started. Because I could see where people get very frustrated learning how to control a car in this game. It's very likely that might happen to you. But having an open parking lot to test in, where you would hit like shopping carts instead of things, just to keep it in the same theme, that to me would be awesome, because that would give you some idea of how the car works, how the physics work, how things break down, how you get stuck, how you get unstuck. But that way you don't have the walls in the way, you don't have those shoppers to worry about, you don't have all that other stuff. I mean, maybe I'm breaking this down a little too far, but that would be one mode I would like to see if I had to offer a suggestion. But other than that, I am actually very impressed with this game at the price point that it's come in at. I've found other games that are less impressive and less interesting for a much higher price point. So for $4 as release, and as I make this video, yeah, I would recommend this. I would say this would be a game you would definitely want to check out if you're looking for something of a different vein to try and play. So yeah, I'm not the best player at it, but it was not the game I expected, but I'm not disappointed in it. Now you know more about what it's about. If the game looks interesting, definitely pick it up and support this developer. A lot of thought and effort went into this game, and honestly, these are the developers that I think we need to support, because if we do, these guys come out with more and more inventive games when they have more resources to do stuff. They don't come out with the same old crap, and this game is definitely not the same old crap you see everybody else coming out with. This game has originality, inventive ideas, difference in play style. I really couldn't ask for more out of it. So if you're looking for a game, you got $5 you want to throw at a developer to help them out rather than help out somebody who asset flips something and just makes a crappy game, because that definitely is not what's going on here. So with that, I'm going to end this. I'd really hope that there would be more depth to it to do more playthroughs, but I think maybe we'll revisit it if they come out with some patches, and maybe we'll play it again a little bit later once I get a little more time with it and see if we do any better. And then we can activate all the abilities. But as it stands right now, at release, this is an early review, early playthrough. I'm liking what I'm seeing. So the game is not in early access. The game has actually been released. So keep that in mind. Definitely check it out. I will put a link to where you can buy it in the description below. And I will put a link to the developer name in there so you can see that as well. Anyway, thanks for watching and take it easy.